on the line with me now is Too Hot to Handle's resident Jesus. We've got Matthew Smith. How are you, Matthew?
Good, good. How are you doing?
The Jesus thing works for you? I mean, you respond to both, right?
I do, yeah. I mean, especially now.
Yeah.
Because it's easier to remember the name Jesus. So if people can't remember my name, they'll yell Jesus, and I guess it's just something I got to get used to.
But hey, it's not bad. Hot Jesus is a pretty good name.
Yeah, I could think of worse people to be referred to, for sure, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. So how are you holding up in quarantine? You look like you're in sunny LA. What have you been doing to keep busy?
Yeah, it's great. This week is 80s. I'm staying at, I'm quarantining myself with, I call him my big brother, Keith Carlos. He won America's Next Top Model this season I was on. So we've been friends ever since then. And yeah, we're staying busy doing yard work and hanging out with, he has a son, so I've been hanging out with him. It's been honestly, like, all things considered, I have nothing to complain about. I'm very fortunate right now. So if boredom is my biggest problem, I'm living an okay life. You know what I mean?
Well said. Nice to hear that from somebody. You know, you're on America's Next Top Model. You're no stranger to reality, but I gotta be honest, everyone's newest obsession is Too Hot to Handle on Netflix. Shh.
Crazy. Find,
yeah, I mean, it's insane, and it also seems like such a good time. How does it feel to finally have the show out to the world?
This one, yes, the show is absolutely blowing any expectations anyone could have. I mean, it's bonkers, really. I was talking to someone the other day, and I just go, you know what I've learned from all of this is that Netflix rules the world. That's what I've gained from all of this. It's been awesome. The feedback has been awesome. People have been really supportive to me, which I've appreciated. A lot of people don't realize that, like, you know, when you see someone in TV or a movie, you kind of assume that, like, when they say, oh, thank you, it means so much, it's just kind of like BS. Well, I can tell you, it's not BS. We're real people, and people's feedback means a lot. Waiting a year was kind of crazy. Like, it honestly, I made a joke, because it did keep getting pushed back and get pushed back and pushed back. And I made a joke to a couple of the guys, Bryce and David. I said, you know, Netflix is kind of starting to feel like the girlfriend that always says she's going to give it up, but never does, and keeps, like, going to, you know, asking you to go to dinner. She's like, no, next time, I promise, next time. And you just go home like, she got me again. Like, I'm never going to get what I want out of this. But it worked out in our favor. The timing couldn't have been better. You know, it is a silver lining. Obviously, trying to make this whole pandemic thing, like, a positive note is hard. Right. But all things considered, for Netflix and viewers on that side of things, it's been a perfect storm, really.
I mean, I couldn't agree more. Now, obviously, like I said, you were on America's Next Top Model. How does this reality experience on Too Hot to Handle differ from, you know, America's Next Top Model outside of gameplay? How is it different for you?
You know, so this show was like the cream of the crop. I mean, I've never done a season one, so you do kind of worry, like, how it's going to look. You have no idea how the edit's going to look. You have no idea what the production value is going to be. So you really do go into this kind of blindly, and you're just trusting the process. And that's nerve-wracking, especially having done something before, like Top Model. You're kind of like, oh man, I can't believe I'm putting myself through this again, because it is definitely a test psychologically. And you have no idea how it's going to be on the back end. Like, on Top Model, I was on cycle 21, so I could watch the show. I got a kind of feel for how it was going to be. I knew for sure, okay, this is a sort of response I'm going to get at the worst case scenario. And when you're doing something completely new, you have no reference. You have no idea how it's going to go. It could be a total flop. You could put yourself through a challenging experience and not enjoy it, and it be a horrible thing. You know what I mean?
Right.
So it requires, this experience required a lot more trust. But with that said, like, I was blown away every single step of the way. They did not, you know, cut corners at all. I mean, we had our home. So before you go into the retreat, we have, obviously, they keep the cast separated so that we don't see each other. We each had our own hotels, like, not our own hotel room. We were in our own hotels. So, like, every single cast member was put in their own, like, all-inclusive resort hotel all along Puerto Vallarta. And you could have, it was like unlimited access to everything. It was like a vacation week prior to even going into the villa, which was then like this incredible place. So it was just top of the line. Every single thing, production, like the people involved, how they treated you, everything was, is, I don't think, that's another joke I made to some of the producers. I was like, you know, after this is aired, I feel like this experience is going to be the like amazing ex-girlfriend that you compare every single date to that like never adds up. Cause I can't see it getting much better than this.